Tonight, the Foundation is absolutely thrilled to be awarding the Sydney Peace Prize to the Black Lives Matter Network. This is the first time that we've awarded the prize to a movement.
And while there is much about this global movement that reminds us of how far we have to go in terms of addressing the deepest roots of racism that continue in our societies that need to be highlighted, challenged and destroyed, this is also a movement that has reminded us of how much we can achieve if we are determined, if we stand together.
If you're not speaking out against violations of human rights, you're not part of the solution, you're part of the problem. And we have to come with the terms of racism before we can start talking about peace.
Their ethos and their movement is so adaptable to different situations around the world. It has the ability to galvanise black people globally.
In 2013, George Zimmerman was acquitted of the murder of Trayvon Martin. Alicia Garza wrote a love letter to black people. It was powerful, and it ended with, "Black Lives Matter." Black Lives Matter has become what black communities all over the world need it to become. It has become a moment and a movement. Black Lives Matter is a global fight. I think the context for Black Lives Matter really comes in a moment where this generation is a generation of forgotten children.
That recognize that black folks are also queer, trans, that recognize that black folks are migrants, that recognize that black folks are indigenous.
We've built whole countries on our backs for nothing, for free, for very little. And to have someone say your life matters, a black life matters, is...
So on behalf of all of us, I ask the leaders, Patrice, Rodney and Dawn, here to accept the prize on behalf of the Global Network. And I thank them for their leadership, for their vision, and for their courage.
Thank you so much, y'all. We really